Now, what is the solution for people who are rich? That's the second category. Just for your knowledge, I would like to tell you that I am the fifth child of my parents. If my parents would have done family planning, I wouldn't have been here. Do you think I am a boon or a bane for society? You know, in the world, in society, best profession, doctor, medical doctor. Best is medical doctor, nothing better than that. Alhamdulillah, even after being the fifth child, I became a medical doctor. But I became a doctor to serve humanity. But when I found a better profession, Allah says in Surah Fussila, chapter 41, verse number 33, وَمَنْ أَحَسَنُ قَالَ مِمَّنْ دَعِلَ اللَّهِ وَعَمِلَ صَالِحًا قَالَ إِنَّنِ مِنَ الْمُسْلِمِينَ. Who is better in speech than one who invites to the way of thy Lord, works righteousness, and says that I am a Muslim? When I found a better profession, I changed from a doctor of body to a doctor of soul. If I was a medical doctor, I am surely there is more than a lakh people here. They wouldn't have come for my talk. They have come because I have changed from a doctor of a body to a doctor of soul. I am asking you, I am the fifth child of my parent. Am I a boon or am I a bane for society? People have a misconception that if you have less children, you can have spacing and you can bring them up well. If you check the list of all the Nobel Prize winners and people who have got awards, best in world, best in science, best in sports, they aren't the first child. They are not the only children. Some may be. Some are second child, some are third, some are fifth. It's mixed. It's a misconception. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given a natural method of spacing. In Islam, the moment a child is born, the mother should breastfeed the child. But today in modern world, you know, they don't want to breastfeed because they spoil their figure. The best food, according to medical science, that you can give to your child is the breast milk. And if you breastfeed your child, automatically there is lactation amenorrhea. You being a doctor, you know, there is lactation amenorrhea. That means she will not conceive. Though it's not 100% safe, but the chances she'll conceive is very little. So automatically Almighty God has given spacing. And population, sister, it is not a bane, it is boon. You know, we say in our country in India, hum do hamare do. We two and our two. Ek ke baad abhi nahi, do ke baad kabhi nahi. After one not now, after two never. So these are slogans in India because Indian government doesn't know how to take care of the population. If you go to America, the children wear a t-shirt. I am my father's tax saver. The more children you have, the less tax they have to pay. You go to Australia, you go to Canada. The moment a child is born, the government gives them allowance. Every child, every month you get allowance. So the government of US, Canada, Australia, they're encouraging population. Why is the government of India discouraging? So it's problem with the government policies, it is not with population. And do you know today, the two countries which are competing for being superpower is China and India. China has the maximum population in the world, India is number two. Today, India and China are competing to be population, they are competing to be the superpower. Why? Because both of them have got manpower. When I say manpower, it means human power, it includes the women also. China and India have got human power. That is the reason today, you find America coming here to invest money, you find the Westerners coming to invest money here, you see the stock marketing going high. Why? Because of population. So population, it is a boon, it is not a bane. So even if you want to make your children doctors and engineers, don't think, you never know, your fifth child may become a doctor or your second child. It is not that if you have more children, then you can space them better. Now there's a third category, a unique category. One someone told me, Brother Zakir, I'm rich. I'm not bothered about bringing up children. You know, I'm rich, so no problem of money. And I'm not bothered about making my son, you know, a doctor or engineer. I want to enjoy life. Third category. So I told him, even for you, if you want to enjoy life, the best is marry early, have children early, so that you can retire early. You know, there are certain communities in India, you know, Gujaratis and all, they marry early, 19, 20, 21. They have children immediately. By the time they reach 35 to 40, their children, they are on the seat of the business. So at the age of 40 they can retire. They have retired at the age of 60 and 70. At the age of 40 their children are taking care of their business. They can enjoy life. So even if you want to enjoy life, marry early, have children, relax and enjoy life. Therefore, personally, as far as my opinion is concerned, I believe with those group of scholars, as far as family planning is concerned, Allah says in the Quran, in Surah Al-Imran, chapter number 3, verse number 54, مَقَرُوا مَقَرَ اللَّهُ وَاللَّهُ خَيْرُ الْمَاقِرِينَ. They planned and plotted. Allah too planned. Allah is the best of planner. So if you think you can plan the family better, you're most welcome. I leave the planning of the family in the hands of a creator. It is the best. Hope that answers the question.
Thank you, sir.
This is next question from the same mic, ladies rear section, mic number 2. The second question from the same mic.
But we don't have any non-Muslim sisters.
Okay, then I would request any of the non-Muslim sisters that are available anywhere close by. If you'd like to ask a question, you can quickly get up and get on the mic. Just wait for about 3 seconds, or I move to the next mic. Any of the sisters, they are requested, if you have any specific question, you are most welcome. Any critical question on Islam or you want clarification on Islam, this is your opportunity. Dr. Zakir is here. Most welcome to go on the mic and put forward your question.